I just got a text. Did you hear something else happen just now? Something bad.
So it wasn't really a formal execution.
Did you see all those police lights?
Did you hear what that guy just said? Something horrible just happened in St. Benedict's.
Why the hurry, boys? Where are you headed?
Cops and criminals get used to red and blue flashing lights. Even after you get numb to them, sometimes they still chill your bones. You can get that feeling that this time, they mean something personal. Thank God you're okay. No, no, Joy, Joy, don't! Damn it!
Lieutenant, caught her sneaking up the side staircase. Says she's a friend of the priest.
Where's Father McCauley? Is he all right?
Just put her in my car. I want to interview her myself. Can somebody remind Broyles that the door's not going to watch itself?
Yes, sir.
It's a simple question, please!
Take it easy on her.
Hey, anybody find Baxter yet?
Nope. Went to the station, drove by his place, nothing. You know, there's definitely something wrong here.
I mean, honestly, have you ever seen anything like this?
Half this stuff feels like a goddamn riddle.
I don't know. I just seem so demented.
Demented? I gotta find this crime scene before they cart away all the evidence.
Thank you. stayed at the hospital, she'd still be alive.
Don't hold too tight to what's keeping you here. Just remember, this wasn't your fault.
I'm sorry.
What else did he do here?
Lady, you still with us? You just stopped talking.
Running away. That's who he's after, not the rest of us.
Okay, all right, everyone, let's get this picture. We've got to get to the reception now. Everybody.
Please, let me through.
Hey,
oh, my God.
Oh,
my God.
Hey, it's a lift.
Let me go. Let me go. He's here.
Look, you need to back off.
These weren't normal Bell Killer murders. These people were just in the way. He was after Iris. I wonder if there's more evidence in Joy's room. Trying to protect Iris. Sure, that won't make it sting any less for Joy. Damn it.
I don't think she's the most ideal roommate. A little rough around the edges, but I'm sure you'll like the room, and in time, you'll both get along really well.
Don't worry. I can get along with most anyone.
Excellent. Well, this is the room. Here we are.
Father? What's wrong?
Go! Go!
Killer came here looking for Joy, but took out Iris instead. This is a friggin' dead end.
So where's Baxter? If he's not here, he's got some explaining to do.
Well, what about you? You see anything? Hmm?
It was somewhere around noon on a Sunday when I got a call from the pastor. He was looking for someone to fix up the old church. It had been sitting up on that hill, abandoned for over 40 years after getting hit by lightning back in 98. It suffered a bunch of fire damage. So, of course, I agreed to help. I knew something was wrong the second I stepped inside. As an inexplicable chill came over me. Anyway, I shook it off and I set to work. As I started tearing up the damaged floorboards, they were all bad. Well, I uncovered an old rat's nest. It seemed like any of the others I'd seen over my 22 years in the construction business, until I saw the scraps of human hair and bones that the rats had used to make it. Well, suddenly I heard the floorboards on the second floor creaking above me, and the sounds of a young girl weeping. Well, you know, I was worried that the damaged section of the ceiling was gonna give away under her weight, so you know, I yelled, "Hey, you know, stop, come down immediately." Well, my voice must have startled her because she went completely silent. So I got up and I went to look for her. When I entered the room upstairs, though, I was surprised to see it completely empty. It only took me, you know, a minute to make my way up there, and I would have heard her run off if she did. But that's when I heard the weeping again, only this time it was coming from the bell tower. So I climbed up the long, treacherous, curving stairs at the top, and I noticed what I thought was dried blood dotting the way. When I finally got up to the belfry, I was just paralyzed with terror. Because lying before me was the withered corpse of a young girl. Judging by her sun-bleached clothes and weathered bones, it seemed like she'd been lying there for the better part of those 40 years the place had been empty. The rats, I mean, they picked her bones clean. I took off running. I didn't stop until I got all the way to town. The ravages of time made it impossible for the authorities to get any identity on this girl. It seems Salem will never know who killed her. Some people still claim to hear her weeping there. As for myself, I never went back.